respectable speakers, respectable board of jury, and my loving audience. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First of all, let me thanks to God Allah, the Lord of the world, the creator of everything in the universe, and the one who give us a mercies and blessings. Salawat and salam, peace be upon to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who guided us from the darkness to the lightness. And I will never forget to thank to Mr. Chairman, who give me an opportunity to deliver a speech under the title, The Islamic Heroes Salahuddin Al-Ayyubi. Who doesn't know Salahuddin Al-Ayyubi? Salahuddin Al-Ayyubi is a Muslim knight who doesn't know word fear. And Salahuddin Al-Ayyubi is even feared by the enemy in the Crusade War. Since childhood, Salahuddin Al-Ayyubi became a very different child, so that his father felt very upset. But someone appeared and advised him, and he say, "You'll never know. Maybe your son will become a king who have reputation very, very bright." Ladies and gentlemen, during his life with his father, Salahuddin always moved and ended up in Mosul, which is the place for Christians and Muslims in Egypt. In there, they are both life with blessings. And Salahuddin also began to study our Quran, memorize hadith, and other Islamic knowledge. Before the arrival of Salahuddin, Egypt was the territory of the Shia kingdoms and other dynasty who wanted a revolution. At the time, the uncle of Salahuddin saw an opportunity to conquer the Shia kingdoms because it will make Jerusalem free from the power of the Crusader. After successfully destroying some of the Crusader, Salahuddin was appointed to be a minister in Egypt. Not so long serving as a minister, Salahuddin was appointed to be a deputy of Caliph of the Ayyubid dynasty. After that, Salahuddin was ready to attack the Crusaders again. The preparation that he did is such as in terms of faith, namely Akidah and Da'wah, which is sticking with the unity and integrity of Islamic, were put to face the Crusader. So, ladies and gentlemen, the war ended with a threat from the Crusader to the Salahuddin and to his armies. And the threat was accepted by Salahuddin, who embraced the Crusaders and make the Crusader leave immediately. Salahuddin's act of giving up was highly valued and respected by his opponents. Finally, Salahuddin was entered the Jerusalem, and the city was returned to the hand of Islam. So the lesson we can take is, it is very good to fight the bad people, but again, we have to face it with Islamic faith, and surely with the help from Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Probably, those are all what I can deliver to you. I'm sorry for maybe there was a mistake. Finally, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.